Gospel of John, this portion of it, does actually in some way relate to the words of Richard Hooker, or the life of Richard Hooker. If you don't all have one, there's more of them outside, and you get it after the service. If you're an Episcopalian and you don't know about any of the other theologians, you should know about Richard Hooker. He's the one who I believe is the glue that keeps us together. Shortly before Jesus' arrest and crucifixion and betrayal, Jesus prayed to his Father for himself, for his disciples, and for all his future believers, which includes us. This prayer is truly remarkable. It's been called the Lord's High Priestly Prayer. It is truly a Lord's Prayer, a title normally given to the more simple prayer that we will be citing later. We learn what weighed heavily on our Lord's mind, knowing that an hour has come. He sought to be glorified by his Father. He was so concerned for the well-being of his disciples, and he wanted his followers to be one, even as he and the Father were one. So, Richard Hooker was born at a time, and actually died at a time when there was a lot of unrest because the Reformations, and we talked last time I was here, a month ago, we talked a little bit about Miles Coverdale and Tyndale, who had translated the Bible into English, and that was part of the Reformation. But the king at the time, King Henry VIII, I can't remember how many wives he'd gone through at one point, but declared the English church to be a separate church. Now, he did not say that this church was Protestant. He maintained to the end that this church was Catholic. The Pope, however, Pope Clement, did not agree with him. He said, "You're part of the Protestant." And so what happened in England was there was just horrible things. Well, this happened other places too, but there were horrible things being done. And there was no unity when it was before Queen Elizabeth I, but the monarchs before her.
Edward II.
Pardon?
Probably Edward II.
No. At any rate, I was thinking about the Catholic ones from Scotland, Mary. And at any rate, they had a lot of problems with the Protestants. The Protestants, of course, them, and they dissolved the monasteries, they took their land. The churches were desecrated. All of the rich vestments and thrown away or burned, whatever. And this got to be really, really, really ugly. And of course, there were people that hung or martyred in other ways. And they were people, by the way, who had formerly been encouraged by the king. I'm thinking of Cromwell. Anyway, it got pretty ugly and people died, all in the name of Jesus. So, Hooker actually is about 20 years younger than the king, King Henry. But he's also. So they were contemporaries, but, then the king died, and then after a couple of other people, Queen Elizabeth I took over, and she was Protestant. And she, however, understood that this turmoil could not go on as intensely as it had been, and there was a act of parliament that was a bridge, a settlement is what they called it, so that you could be Roman Catholic or you could be Anglican and not have your house burned down, whatever that the words actually were. So Hooker was a scholar, was a theologian, as I said, and he wrote a lot of things. And he, let me see if there's one in particular that I wanted to mention. He totally supported the Book of Common Prayer, and he said, the church is always a visible society, he used the word men, not an assembly, but a society, although the name of the church to be given unto Christian assemblies, although any multitude of Christian people, I'm going to say, congregated may be termed by the name of a church, yet assemblies properly are rather things that belong to a church. They must assemble for the glory of God. His masterpiece work was the Laws of the Ecclesiastical Polity. And this is where we hear about a three-legged stool, okay? We're not saying that only scripture is allowed, as the Puritans did. Puritans were at that time very insistent, I'll just use that word, about there not being any bowing or crossing or vestments, or the communion was not the body of Christ, it was totally a memorial. So Hooker said that we have a three-legged stool. We have scripture, but we also have tradition and we have reason. Okay? So that really widened the ability to be in communion with other people who go to church. And you don't have to fight about it. You have a Catholic wing of the church, so to speak, and you have a Protestant wing, but you have a middle way. We are all of the middle way, even if some of us are not what we call, I hate to use this word, but high church, which is the ceremonial stuff, or low church, which is almost none of it, that doesn't matter, is what he's saying. And he, of course, wrote five books on this, on the whole thing. But that's the reason why the gospel today is all about Jesus' words to God. He's praying for unity. And we should be praying for unity. And in our 2022 day, we're not fighting very much, I hope, about polity, the laws of the church. What we are concerned with is a different kind of unity. It's a unity to accept people, period. Whether they're like us or not like us, whoever us is. And I've been in the us, that's the white privileged us, and I've also been in the us, that's the minority us. And many of our loved ones may have very different feelings than we do, but we're supposed to love them anyway. And you know what? If you can remember the gospel that Jesus prayed for unity, then remember that while we're looking at someone that's very different than yourself.